Karan, welcome. Karan, to you first. Technology seems to have moved so fast just in the last couple of years. How have you seen the telco industry, I suppose the mindset of the telco industry, change over that time? Or has it?
Well, over the last year, I mean, I think we have gone from a buzzword, especially when it comes to AI, to a more practical application, where what really comes down to is how it's applied in business. And I think businesses get that now. And we see that pace accelerating with the real application of AI or Gen AI into use cases that can add value to their cost or revenue.
So if I was to sit here with you next year, what are you hoping to be answering to that question?
I'm really excited about multimodal AI or especially new applications of it. Going back to the fact that I said we should be more practical. I'm excited about what voice can do with AI in real applications again, right? The impact that it's going to have on call centers and again, business, like unlocking real value. I think that's super exciting.
Taryn, what are the challenges that telcos face in really getting the most out of this these new technologies?
Yeah, I think the challenges have also evolved over time. If you were here last year, the challenge was, why do I need this? The question was all about why? And from there, it has become how this year, right? And we have never seen such a fast change in the mindsets of the CEOs. Just to give you a stat, we recently surveyed about 2,000 odd top executives, and about 65% of them believe AI is the number one priority, but only less than a quarter of them actually are doing something real about it. This starkness of something being priority versus the actual implementation continues to be bizarre. So I think that is the biggest challenge. And if I just go underneath it, I don't think the challenge is on the technology or the platforms or the algorithms or the LLMs. It is how actually you're fundamentally rethinking your entire business operations to reflect this. Instead of looking at AI as a tool, you're looking at the problem statement and trying to solve this leveraging AI as an enabler. That mindset change is the biggest challenge that I see in my clients.
I want to go more deep into that statistic, that gap that you've just pointed out, because clearly the will is there, the priority is there, but just the execution's lacking. So what is the one stumbling block, what perhaps one piece of advice would you give?
Yeah, so I think most observation that we are doing around this one is the fact that we see our clients looking at a new shiny tool and trying to put it into action. Instead, the question should be different. I have a real problem to solve. I have a business problem to solve. I have to go and change the experience of a customer, or I have to go back and change my network operations. I have a cost problem to solve. And then coming to the technology and say, how can technology help me solve that problem? That mindset is the one which we think is a differentiation between the haves and the has-nots.
Karan, what would you say? Your one piece of advice, I suppose.
I agree with Taryn. I think, again, I'm having gone through this year, I think we need to move away from the shiny object or shiny tool, toy. We need to look at the real applications of AI into businesses. And we've seen that. Some of our partners who we have kind of had this journey with over the last year, they're starting to unlock double-digit benefits in the use cases that AI has implemented it. And I think with that pace will accelerate over the year. And then we should really go from it being, again, hype to something that I think is, again, an organizational efficiency unlock.
Karan, Taryn, thank you so much. An absolute pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you for having us here.